So dear student, today I will try to show how to do the viability test using the tetrazolium solution. So tetrazolium is one type of salt. They usually stream the viable parts of the seed, mostly the ovule. So before doing that experiment, at least 24 hours before we have to soak the seed, and next we have to cut in different position. Then we have to soak again in tetrazolium solution of different concentration. It may be 0.1, 0.5 or 1% based on different species. Then after that we have to keep the beaker or whatever we keep in the seed in the solution, tetrazolium solution, keep in the water bath 35 to 40 degrees Celsius for several hours. So after that we can see the seeds, those seeds, it strain the color from the tetrazolium. So if the full ovule, the full of ovule parts, they attain the color, that means they are 100% viable. If partial, that means they partially viable. If not, then that means fully died already, to dead seeds. So we cannot use for the germination. So now I'm sure this is the tetrazolium solution, tetrazolium powder. So from here today I will make 0.5% solution. So 0.5%, that means 0.5 gram in 100 ml water. So to save the chemical, today I will do 0.25 gram in 50 ml water. The meaning is that 0.5% solution of tetrazolium. So how to do that? So I have already, this is our balance, so making zero. So this is actually, this is beaker. So this beaker we have to make zero first. So this is making zero. So when we see the zero, then we have to coat the tetrazolium powder, 0.25 gram. So this is the very small spatula. So we put inside 0.25. Slowly you have to add. And pour it, the chemical finish already. So you have to make 0.25. Close to the amount. So now have to be very careful. 0.24. You can see the balance. Okay, so this one is 0.25. So now I will add 50 ml water inside that solution. So in the beaker already have the measurement, so 100 ml. So this is the distilled water. So I am adding distilled water until 50 ml. So this is almost 50 ml, you can see. Yeah, we have to add a little bit more. Okay, so this is meaning is that, so now we can stir properly using the spatula to dissolve properly. So almost dissolved. So you have to stir properly until completely dissolve the powder. Okay, so that means our 0.5% tetrazolam solution already prepared. Now we have to go for the dissection of the seed. And after dissection, we will soak in that solution. Okay, so we need to proceed for the. So I have already, we have several types of seed here. This is corn seed. This one is rice seed. And also some other seed here. So we have to remove the water first. Then I will show. So we have to remove the water. Or one by one we can take the seed. So initially, using the forceps, we can take some seed. Better to take healthy seed. So corn seed actually, sometimes we need to soak more than 24 hours because the is very dry. This is corn. So I have some also other the bean seed. This is an hyacinth bean. This one okra. This one is the this one the pumpkin seed, and I have also some chili seed. This one is chili. Okay, so I have also soaked the sweet corn. This one, sorry, popcorn. This one is normal corn, and this one is popcorn. Okay, so we have also rice seed. So we can take some rice seed as well. Okay. Okay. So now we have to dissect the seed in by different position. Take more. We also soak some brinjal seed as well. Okay, so now we have to cut the seed to soak inside the. So firstly, I have to cut like this, the longitudinal one. Still the seed is not soaked properly. So this is one way, and we can also cut this way. Okay. So this seed also. So inside the whitish part, the below this one is actually the ovule. If the seed is viable, then the seed, the ovule will absorb the color, usually close to red color. Okay. So we have to soak, so I am trying to cut all the seeds slowly. Have to soak in the solution. So this one is your long bean. So one I should cut from here. Okay, then another one is like this. Okay, this one is okra seed. So one is throw, okay. And one is roundly. Okay.
competition is by holding very difficult round, so this will be very hard yet. This one is very hard. Maybe you have to check another seat. Maybe those seat is very hard. Meaning is that I have already soaked about 2 days, but it's still hard. Meaning is that they may be already died. Okay, so it's only one. This is pumpkin seed. So pumpkin seed is flat type, so better cut from here. So we use another cutting from here. Okay. Then for the rice, cutting, that means you have to remove the husk. But while removing, you have to be careful that you should not damage the tubule. Okay. So you have to remove the husk very carefully because the ovule is here. Oh, I think not soaked fully. Broken, no problem, but still the ovule is on side. The so far the seed is very dry, so very hard to cut. So in the last lecture we tried to show this is the whitish color, this is the ovule inside. So we have to be careful about the ovule, we should not damage. So we have to remove the husk. Sometimes very tedious job. Okay, so the still is ovule there, so we can keep. And for the kitchen is chili seed. You see very small, and 2 days I soaked that one. So very sharply you have to cut. Chili seed is hard. Small seed very difficult to dissect, but still we have to try. This one is brinjal seed. Okay. So I am using so many different types of seed to see whether how they absorb the color. Different seeds, maybe their pattern of absorption is different. Okay. So after that, all seeds we have to keep the tetrazolium solution. So I have already prepared the 50% tetrazolium solution. So you have to put all the seeds inside. Okay, one by one you can keep all the seeds. Okay, that means all the seed inside. Now we have to keep in the water bath. So we can, okay, so you can inside the water bath, you can see there is the stand or rack. So we have to keep on that. And the temperature we have to maintain 35 to 40 degrees Celsius. And we have to wait. We have to wait several hours. So you can see we are maintaining the temperature 35 to 40, so it's close to 40. And we have kiki, you can see keep the inside, there have the stand. So on the stand, the water is almost the warm, not hot water, it's called warm water. So you have to keep several hours. So after that we have to bring out and we have to see how many seeds they have absorbed the color from the tetrazolium. Usually reddish color, close to reddish color. So those seeds are 100% viable. All the parts, that means the entire ovule will absorb the color. If not, maybe partially, then we can say the seed is partially alive. If not, if they do not absorb color, that means the seed is dead. So this is called tetrazolium test. So after few hours, then we will bring out and we will see what is happening there. By this way, I can ensure the viability of the test. So maybe later I will show how they have absorbed the color. So that's all from the tetrazolium today. But I will add when they have absorbed the color, the result. So thank you everyone. A few years back, we already soaked our dissected seed in tetrazolium solution and kept in the water bath. So I just bring out from the water bath. So now I am trying to show you how those seeds are viable and they have absorbed the color from the tetrazolium salt. So you can see I have already bring out all the seeds. So those seeds are, you can see this is the embryo. This one is the popcorn. So you can see the entire embryo is completely colored, red colored. That means they are fully viable. This one is the year-long bean. So this is the embryo and the entire in some of the cotyledons are also absorb the color. That means we can consider they are also viable. So this is the pumpkin seed. You can see by different types of section. So very nicely absorb the color. That means they are also viable. So this is the rice. So you can see the embryo and the endosperm as well. So embryo is, they are still viable because of they have absorbed the color. So if you see that on this corn, so they didn't absorb the color, or maybe very minor, very little bit colored absorbed. So that means they are almost dead, this one. And this one almost dead because there is no formation of the color. This one is looks like a little bit complicated, but still we can see the embryo have absorbed some color. So maybe this we see the formation, the seed structure a little bit different. So maybe they are viable. So this is the all about the our tetrazolium test for the viability analysis. So before going for germination, after sampling, we can take some seeds and soak in tetrazolium solution
for several hours in water bath. There we can bring out, and if we see also how many percentage of the seed they have absorbed color, the red color from the tetrazolam solution. If the fully color, especially the emphasis one, the embryo. If the entire embryo they absorb color, we can consider the seeds are 100% viable. If partial or no color, then we have to consider they are not viable. So this was the steps and the different procedure how we can do the viability analysis using the tetrazolium salt. So this is also called tetrazolium analysis or the viability analysis for seed viability test. So that's all about the viability analysis using tetrazolium salt. So that's all from me today. So thank you so much. And in the later we will come up with again with other different types of analysis.